Hi guys. Recently guy came up to me and he was just kept asking me. He was grumbling about the problems, the troubles and the difficulties he was just going through. He had just recently lost his job for no reason. His relationship was like in the mess. Nobody was like, you know, was trying to understand. Everything was just going wrong. He had done nothing wrong at all. And all through conversation, he kept asking me, why this happens to me only? Why is this happening to me only? I'm sure a lot of you can relate to the situation that this guy was just going through. I told him, like, look man, do what you can do to sort it out. If it's your fault, correct it. If it's someone else's fault, and that person is like within your access, discuss with them. Communicate to them very often. However, what we go through is neither our fault nor the fault of someone else. For example, a serious disease that we go through, we didn't do anything wrong to get it. And nobody else did anything wrong to have it, not to get it. How do we deal with it then? How? When we go through the helpless, overwhelming challenges in our life, for no fault of ours, no fault of anybody else, we cannot do anything to sort it out. If we see and look at it from our point of view, all we see is a mess. All we see is a situation and an event tangled jumbled up to create that mess. But when we look at the same situation from life's point of view, from the God's point of view, we see a beautiful design, a pattern, a plan evolving in our lives. In fact, for a beautiful design of embroidery to happen on one side, you cannot avoid the mess on, you know, other side. See, this is a cutting. If you will see, this design is different and this one is different. This one is beautiful, but this one is a work of threads. So for a beautiful design of embroidery to happen on one side, you cannot avoid the mess on the other side. And it's not just the nature of embroidery. It's just a nature of life as well. This outlook actually gives us a very deep sense of inner strength. And for, give us strength to face such helpless and overwhelming challenges in our life. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, in our life, like, we have a lot of challenges, you know. Here, what we have to do, what we're supposed to do. Let's take an example of a little boy. A little boy once coming, you know, like, which is running to his mother and asking, okay, what are you doing, mom? She replied, I am making a beautiful embroidery, a design on his cloth. The little boy looked up to the cloth and surely had the wooden ring, the hoop and it's like a round kind of framework. And he complained, a design? All I can see is just a colored mess, a colored threads, which is like in a mess. So I was like, it's a colored threads, yellow, blue, red, pink and all tangled up, messed up in each other, all the complicated, and you call it design? The mother picked up the little boy and put him on her lap. And said to him, now look at it, my son. And the boy saw a beautiful design, an incredible pattern, a systematic plan and a layout evolving on this cloth. So the mother said to the boy, when you look at the cloth from one side, all you see is a mess. When you look at the clothes from other side, you will see a beautiful design, a pattern, a plan. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, in our life too, in our life, if I say change your vision will change you. Thank you so much. So be confident in your life and be happy.